evening, my beauties, from the wondrous and wonderful Epcot. Yeah, this one, I'm basically here almost every single day. Aside from that, we're here for two reasons. Reason number one, to get the Figment Passholder Magnet that has surprisingly gone extremely viral, honestly, rightfully, respectfully so. And I know I'm very, very late to that game. I do apologize. I was at Sonic Temple, blah, blah, blah. You get the picture. Reason number two is to check out what they are calling the Passholder Lounge, but what I and many others am calling just a little roped off section of Sunshine Seasons. Now, as always, if you guys do end up enjoying today's vlog, make sure you like, subscribe, and ring that bell. But with all that out of the way, let's head on in and have some fun. Now, in terms of today's crowds, oh, wow. A lot of people are leaving. Ooh, fingers crossed that we can go on some good rides. So I guess the Figment Passholder Magnet is in Creations. At least I know that's where the Dumbo one was. So already, there is, oh, quite the line to get one. In fact, the line is, oh gosh, it's literally outside. Yeah, you know, it's a good thing that we're only here for two things.
2 hours later.
Thanks, Aiden.
Thank you. Oh boy. Oh my gosh, that's so cute. Now, if you know me, you know I love Figment. So this, oh my gosh, this might be the best pass holder magnet yet. But alas, because today, June 9th, is my mother's birthday, this will be going out to her. It'll probably be there well before this vlog gets uploaded. But in the case that it doesn't, yeah, Mom, this is already being sent out to you, so no take backs. First thing we needed to do, taken care of, all out of the way. So now, see, we got some time. Let's try and go on some rides. Now, naturally, after you get a Figment Passholder Magnet, you then take a journey into imagination with said Passholder Magnet.
Welcome, welcome, welcome to our special drive-through open house. I'm Dr. Michael Kelly, chairman of the Imagination Institute. Hello! On your tour, you'll see how the five human senses can help capture your imagination.
Oh, oh, can I go too?
Absolutely not. This is one of our discoveries, the Figment of Imagination.
Yeah, I know all about the senses. There's sight, sound, smell, touch, goochie goochie go, and taste. Taste like chicken. Can I go? Please, please, please.
No, I don't want you out of my sight.
Out of sight? Okay. Come on, everybody. Here we go.
Our first stop is the sound lab. We'll begin by testing your hearing with a series of tones.
Left ear,
right ear. Left, right. What? This is odd. Hello? Who is this?
It's Figment!
Figment? I thought I told you not to interfere.
But you've got it wrong, Doc. It's not about listening with your ears. It's about listening with your imagination.
Now I've completely lost my train of thought.
No, you haven't. It's over here! All aboard! Woo-hoo! Next stop, imagination!
Continuing now, if I may, in a calm, scientific,
Figment-free manner.
The things we see with our eyes can control the eyes of the imagination. Let's begin by using the eye chart to test your vision. Now, all together, if you would please read line three.
With F-I-G-M-E-N-T, you can see things differently. Sure, you can see with your eyes, but imagine what you could see if you used your imagination. Follow the bouncing Figment. One spark of light can light your fancy. Your mind sees more than what your eyes see. Your sense of sight can make your fancy fly. There's more to sight. Come into play. I'd love to.
This is not a good time.
It's always a good time to use your imagination. So let the good times roll.
Woohoo! You win 1 cent.
But don't.
Oh.
Yeah. Woo. Really sticks.
Of course, Doc. The
oh. Oh, man. That one's really strong today.
You know, I'm sorry, but after that big stink in the smell lab, I hesitate to send you into the touch and taste labs. Perhaps I should end my open house right here.
Great idea. We'll go to my open house instead. It's much more fun. Right this way, everybody.
Figment, what is going on? You're turning this entire open house upside down.
Upside down? Now you're talking. That's the best idea you've had all day. With just a spark of
Imagination works the best when it's set free.
You said it, Doc. Imagination is a blast.
Creation, right at the start of everything that's new. One little spark lights up for you.
Voilà, venez, 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 suivez-moi, je vous prie.
Chef Remy is waiting for you. This way.
Des invités pour le dîner.
Yes, but what about here? Hein? Pour le repas, il est là. Pourquoi pas?
Oh, yummy!
C'est pour maman.
Too simple.
What?
Me, oui, that's it. Tables are cute, I will say that. Let's see, can we find a table all the way back here? Oh, I see a Figma table. I see a Figma table, I am taking it. I am so taking this Figma table.
They also gave us some free goodies, such as some crunchy cookie M&Ms. I might eat these, not really big into candy anymore. They also gave us a Figma annual pass holder sticker. Peace focus, hey, I felt focused on it. It's actually really cute. Honestly, I might put this on my computer. In terms of what the AP Lounge is, I have seen numerous pictures, numerous videos. My opinion, it is nothing special. It is honestly just as bad as Universal's. They give out free water. It looks like they have free lockers. I don't really know. But really, this is just, if you remember back during the times of COVID, they had their relaxation stations. This is pretty much that, except it's only for annual pass holders. I mean, again, you get free water. That's good. But other than that, it's nothing special. Honestly, just sitting here for a few minutes just feels meh. That's the only impression I'm getting, is just meh. If you have a choice, just go to the DVC Lounge at Imagination. It's over there, free sodas and free snacks. All we got was a free bag of M&Ms near expiration and a Figment sticker. The Figment sticker is definitely cute. I'll definitely put it on something. Maybe I'll put it on my guitar. But you know what? I am a little dehydrated, so free water never hurts. Except for the fact that you can literally get free ice water at any Walt Disney World quick service. All you have to do is ask. In fact, I actually talk about it religiously, that you are much better off just spending the extra 5-10 minutes to go to a quick service and get their water instead of drinking from the terrible, disgusting water fountains that they have throughout property.
I should mention it too, they also sell these pretty cute looking snacks. Raspberry lemonade tart, the spark of grape shake. I do want to try that next time I'm in here. Just other than that, this place is nothing special.
Now, I'm not gonna say that this AP Lounge is generally bad, because it has all the stuff that you need. Free water, a free snack. I doubt that's gonna be a forever thing. Those lockers were actually charging stations. I don't know if the Universal Annual Pass Holder Lounge has those. I know they just have outlets and stuff in the walls to where if you bring your own stuff, you can charge your phone. So that is definitely a plus. I could definitely see myself using that, except for the fact that this is only a limited time thing, whereas with Universal, that's a year-round thing. So that's a benefit that I will give them. But if I could rate this AP Lounge, I'd give it maybe a 6 out of 10. For me, it's just way too small. And given the amount of APs that Disney has, especially now that they've since resumed new AP sales, yeah, I can see it getting very, very busy. Busy enough, in fact, to where a decent line was actually forming by the time I was leaving.
Welcome, people of Epcot.
Epcotters. Epcotians. Citizens of Epcot.
Does anyone know what they call themselves?
What?
I'm on? Someone needs to tell me what I'm on. Welcome, Epcot Terrans. I am Centurion Tal Merrick, and we're just about ready to teleport you up to the ship for the demonstration. As you're about to enter a secure Nova area, I must ask you to put away your Terran communication devices at this time. Recording of any type is strictly prohibited. I am very serious about this. Now, please step forward into the chamber. You're gonna love this.
Oh. I can't.
Not at E-stop. I'm sorry, that was just terrible, terrible timing.
Looks like no teleportation for us.
I mean, at the same time, at least it's pretty cool to see the teleportation room with the lights on.
Okay, they're headed for the jump point. This plane is never gonna work.
Rocket!
Well?
Okay, I've locked onto your vehicle.
We'll be right behind you.
Nothing to worry about.
Unless we cannot stop this unusually large man, then you're likely doomed.
Drax!
Uh-oh.
Good luck! You gotta need it.
Terrans, this is Centurion Merrick again. We're having a little bit of trouble with our ship's airlock, and it appears we need to open it manually.
Oh, we got it!
You're good to go! Let's do this!
To follow me. What is that noise?
Noise? No one's gonna stop rock and roll from existing.
What have you done?
What have we done?
I think we're coming back.
Woo!
Oh, yeah. How about that?
said that all the time. Anytime.
Okay.
We have no room in our ship for these new guards.
Drax, it's an honorary title. They're not coming with us.
I see. It is meaningless. Well, then welcome to the Guardians of the Galaxy. Now, where's that K-Toast?
And with that, my beauties, we have since captured the objective. We got our magnet, and we checked out the AP lounge. One of them was good, one of them was bad. You decide on that.
Well, hello, my beauties. Check this out. I am home, yet again, literally 3 weeks later. But you know, this, I think, is the benefit of going full-time on YouTube, is that I have the absolute utmost freedom to basically come home whenever I want.
But let's walk, walk, walk. Where is he? Hi! It's the little baby! It's a little baby Gizmo! Oh, he's so cute! Look, he looks so good! He looks so good, his tail's growing back! You don't like it when I touch your tail? Aw, he's so cute!
But in all seriousness, I am home for the weekend for the sister's graduation party. She's in her room, yeah. So let's talk about Epcot really quickly. Ooh, that exposure is a little high. Can we turn that down? 3200 ISO should work. Still figuring this stuff out. Interesting day to say the least. We weren't there for very long. We were there for like maybe 3 hours. We were only really there to check out the pass holder magnet and the pass holder lounge, one of which is good, one of which is bad. I still stand by that opinion. But of course, we also did Figment. Of course, we did Ratatouille. I always, always, always go on Ratatouille and Guardians. You cannot forget about Guardians when you go to Epcot. I think with the summer coming along, I'm gonna test out doing shorter vlogs. I know this vlog is gonna be like maybe 15, 20 minutes, but keep in mind, I'm only at the parks for like maybe 3 to 5 hours. And it's just because of the fact that I'm able to get so much footage in that amount of time. So I think because of this, I'm gonna start asking you guys, what is a specific thing that you want me to do at the parks? Whether it's a ride, whether it's a restaurant, merchandise, you name it. If there's a specific thing that you want me to vlog at the theme parks, let me know. But I am going to relax, because while I've been home for maybe 5 hours now. I don't even want to talk about the flight up here. So we're gonna move the camera into the other hand so I can do my outro. Yeah, I do not like this angle. I don't really know why, but we do this every single week. So make sure you like, subscribe, and ring that bell. All right, my beauties, I love y'all. Take care, and I'll see y'all next time.